Welcome back to another photography challenge. This week, the theme is shifting the frame, and we'll talk about shifting a frame in both time and space. Let's jump in and get started and see some examples that should help you out. So, the photography this week will be due on Thursday night. Look for instructions on Google Classroom and how you're going to be turning that in. The quote for the week is, "If you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change." And it's a perfect quote for the theme we're about to have. So hang on and let's figure out how that fits. But before, we got to get philosophical. Photography and truth have an interesting relationship. People are more likely to believe things that they've seen. However, a picture is just one small rectangle of a larger image. Where a photographer stands, what they choose to include in the frame, and what they purposely or accidentally leave out of a frame each tell a part of a story, and each shape the truth in a way that the photographer can control. So, Photoshop aside, all photos aren't to be believed entirely, and when you change the frame, you change the meaning and change the truth of the story. So you're going to be a storyteller through this, and I'll show you what that looks like. So we're going to talk about shifting a frame and changing the meaning and changing the truth of an image. First thing that you can shift is time. So you can tell a story of change and a story of impact and a story of power when you shift the time a picture is of. So here's one simple story, a flower wilting and going away. Same exact frame, and the image changes over time. Here's a little bit longer time, one whole year of an exact same frame to show a story of time. Here's a trend that's happening lately. This is a much larger change over time, but people recreating a photo over time is a shift, and it tells a story about relationships and meaning over time. Here's one that I've really found interesting. This is a moment before somebody gets hit by a water balloon, and you've got the moment during the hit. So you can talk about changing people from one moment to the next. This one, you can watch it on the slideshow. A high school photographer asked or told people they were beautiful and recorded their reactions and took pictures of them before and after they were told they were beautiful. She shared those online, and it's the same person, and just a moment later, and the thing between the line here is them being told they're beautiful, and she captured how their whole effect changed between that. The other thing that you can shift is position, and what position, I'm talking about your position or the camera's position of where it is and what it's focusing on. So sometimes what we leave out is more important than what we choose to show. You can get closer to something to change the meaning. You can get further away. You can move your position from the left to the right or in front to behind. So what are you going to choose to show and leave out, and what details can you emphasize in different ways? Here's a famous example. Now during this COVID-19, they opened up beaches in Florida, and you can get a picture that makes it look really crowded. But what they found was that the photographers were shooting the picture in a way to emphasize crowds with photos like this, but then aerial photos of similar time. So there's that same bridge that you saw in this image. But if you look at aerial photos, you can see people being reasonably spaced out and traveling in family groups. So as you change your perspective, you do change the way that the audience interprets your story. You can have this picture of a line, but then from the other perspective, with similar or same exact people in the line, you can change the way that people view the meaning of your photograph. So yes, both these photos are actual non-photoshopped photos. The only thing that the photographer did was change their position. Here's the image of the pyramids that we all know and love, but did you know that they're right this close to civilization? You can see it here, and you can even see that there's a Pizza Hut that's right by the pyramids that you can look out. Great photograph. Same thing here of the Pantheon. Great looking picture of it, but did you know that you can walk out of the McDonald's and right in front of the Pantheon? So different perspectives. Here's one that I tried in the spirit of this competition or this challenge. This is a photograph, and then when you change the position, this is what that picture was actually of. So looking at it from directly on top, it's a circle, but then doing this, it's a different shape entirely. So same object, different perspective, different meaning. Here's some high school photographers that did an assignment similar to this. One object, different perspectives. Here's a different way of looking at a blade of grass. So same blade, different perspective, tells a different story and focuses on different things. So as you do this, think about what you want to do. You want to be thoughtful and take risks. Don't be afraid to make a mistake with this. Don't just take two photos, take 20 photos and pick the best two. Know that there's more than one right answer. That's what this is all about. This theme is all about looking for the next right answer and pushing yourself to keep going for one more shot. And then pay attention to the background that you include and try to get the whole story in the frame. And then cut out things from the frame that aren't a part of the story. Maybe it'll feel disingenuous to the journalists out there, but you're going for stories and meaning here. And you're not being dishonest. You're just choosing to bring readers' attention to different things. So turn in your photos this week. I can't wait to see and talk about them. You are a storyteller. Let's do this.